Hello and welcome to the course on design of bus elements. So today we are going to see some numericals on belt drives, and we will start our presentation here with the first numerical on belt drive. So that is here the numerical statement is given as like this. So the belt drive transmitting 15 kilowatt per power is shown here. Like, this is one input pulley, this is output pulley, and the center distance between these pulleys is given to us. This is equal to 2 times the larger pulley diameter, and it is required that the belt should operate at a speed of 20 meter per second, and the stress in the belt, it should not exceed 2.25 newton per mm square belt stress, while the density of the leather belt which is used in this particular application is 0.95 grams per cubic centimeter, and the coefficient of friction is 0.35 between the belt and the pulley, while the thickness of the belt is given, which is equal to 5 mm, and we are asked to calculate the diameter of pulleys, means this small pulley diameter and larger pulley diameter, then the length and width of the belt, so total length of the belt and width of the belt, which is not known to us, only thickness is known to us, and the tensions in the belt. So first of all, we will see that this is the total data given to us. So power transmission capacity is 15 kilowatt, and the belt velocity is 20 meter per second, center distance. So initially we will mark all these given data, like belt thickness given, density of material, belt stress, coefficient of friction, input speed. We are going to mark it as N1 input speed, N2 is the output speed, 480 rpm, and we are calling B1 is the input pulley diameter and D2 as the output pulley diameter. So now, first of all, we have been given the diameter to be calculated for the input pulley and output pulley. So velocity specified to us, that is 20 meter per second is the velocity specified. So we will be using the equation of velocity, V is equal to pi D1 N1 by 60. So in this equation now, only this D1 is the unknown that you have to find out. So I will write this D1 by rearranging the terms of this equation of velocity at V into 60,000, because I am considering this diameter in mm. Therefore, I have to divide it by 6,000 so that I can use this velocity, which is in meter per second, because velocity is in meter per second, and therefore I have to multiply it into mm. So I am multiplying it by 1000 additionally. So V into 60,000 upon pi into N1. So this gives me diameter of input pulley 265.26, which is going to be near about 270 mm diameter D1. Now diameter of the pulley you have got, that is D1. So accordingly now we will try to get the output pulley diameter. So considering the same velocity on the input and the output side of the pulleys, so maintaining the same velocity ratio, we will get D2 by D1 is equal to N1 by N2, and therefore D2 will be equal to N1 into D1 by D2. So N1 is 1440 rpm, D1 we have got 270 from here, we are going to put it here, and 480 is the N2 output rpm. So we are getting 810 mm is the diameter of the pulley at the output. So after this, we will try to calculate the length of belt. So for length of belt of an open belt drive, the formula is 2c plus pi into d1 plus d2 by 2 plus pi into d2 minus d1 bracket square divided by 4c. So for this I need the center distance first, then diameter of the pulley d1 and d2. So center distance is given as 2 times the diameter of larger pulley, so d2, so that is equal to 2 into 810, that is 1620, and d1 d2 we already got in the previous slide, that is 270 and 810. So we'll be using these values, 270 and 810 as d1 and d2, while c is 1620 mm. So we are getting the total length of belt required for this drive is 4981.1 46 mm, which will round up to 4982 mm. Now we have to find out the tensions in the belt. So once we have got the diameter of the pulley D1 and D2, which is being rounded values, so definitely the velocity will change. So we will find out the correct belt velocity now by using the new diameter of D1, that is pi into D1 into N1 by 60. So pi into 270 into 1440 divided by 60,000, because here again it should be 60,000. So to get the velocity in meter per second, and the angle of wrap for the smaller pulley we will try to determine now. So angle of wrap is given by 180 minus 2 into sin inverse of D2 minus D1 by twice C. So 180 minus 2 into sin inverse of D2 is 810 minus 270 divided by 2 into 1620. So this way you will get this alpha in radians. It will be 2.81 radian. Now the ratio of belt tensions is given by T1 minus mv square upon T2 minus mv square is equal to e raised to mu into alpha. So we'll put the value of mu, which is 0.35 given in the statement, and we have got 2.81 radian here as the value of alpha. So this ratio of belt tensions will be 2.67. Now after this, since we have this mv square in the equation of belt tensions, so we have to find out the value of this mv square first. So we will use the volume of belt first. So volume of the belt is given by length of belt multiplied by width of the belt multiplied by thickness of the belt in cubic centimeter. So if I use the length as 1 meter, for 1 meter length if I have to calculate this volume, so I will be using this length in centimeter as 100, so b by 10, because this is unknown, which is to be found out, and thickness is given to us, so thickness by 10, so this will be in centimeter cube. Now I have converted this in centimeter cube because density is given to me in gram per centimeter cube. So when I am multiplying this density in gram per centimeter cube, multiply by centimeter cube, so I will get this gram per meter. So because centimeter cube will cancel out, and I will get this gram per meter, because this mass, actually this volume I have considered per meter. Now it is 4.75 into 10 raised to minus 3 times b kilogram per meter. So I am multiplying by 10 raised to minus 3 to make this gram into kilogram. So mv square value I have to calculate, so it will be 4.75 into 10 raised to minus 3 into b into 20.36 bracket square, because this is nothing but my modified or corrected velocity. So I will get 1.97 times b as the value of mv square. Now I will try to get the actual values of the belt tensions. So I was having this equation T1 upon T1 minus mv square upon T2 minus mv square e raised to mu alpha. So we have got this already value. So I am just putting the value of mv square here, that is 1.97b upon, and this is also 1.97b for mv square. So now I will cross multiply this. So this T2 into 1.97b will be multiplied by this 2.67. So T1 minus 2.67 times T2 plus 3.29b will be equal to 0. So this is what one equation which I have got in terms of T1, T2 and b. So there are three unknowns in this equation now. So definitely to solve the values or to get the values of T1, T2 and b, I need two more equations, because this is one of the equation. So I need two more equations to get the values of these three constants. We know that the maximum stress in the belt is 2.25 newton per mm square, which is given to us. So this maximum tension, generally it is tensile stress acting in the belt. So maximum tension by the cross section of the belt is given by this ratio will be T max by A. So T max is nothing but the maximum tension, that is T1. So stress into area, I will get sigma into A equal to 2.25 into T into B. So this is cross sectional area, T into B, and this is stress. So B I have to find out, thickness is given to me, so 2.25 into 5 will be equal to 11.25 times B. So this is second equation which I got for the T1. Now one more equation is with us, that is the power transmitted by the belt driver, which is given by P is equal to T1 minus T2 into V. So T1 minus T2 is equal to P by V, because I have to put the get the value of this T1 minus T2 here. So power is known to me, that is 15 to 10 to 3 kilowatt. Velocity I have got corrected velocity 20.36, So I will get is 746.74. So this is my third equation. Now I will use this third equation and the previous two equations. In this, it is value of T1. This is the value of T1, T2 and B in that equation number 1. So combining these three, I will get the value of width of belt is equal to 127.202, which is nearly equal to 130 mm. And the belt tensions, TC will be equal to 1.97 times 130. So it will be 256.1 Newton. And therefore, T1 is equal to 1428.98 and T2 is equal to 692.26. Now, our next aim is to just check whatever the design we have completed, whether it is correct or not. So how we can make the check over this particular design? So we know that the maximum allowable stress in the belt is 2.25 Newton per mm square. Now we will try to find out the induced stress in this. So induced stress will be again the maximum tension in the belt and the cross section of the belt. So T max is nothing but T1, which is 1428.98 divided by cross section area, which is B into T, so 130 into 5, that is 650 mm square. So if I find out this ratio, it is 2.19 Newton per mm square. So as the induced stress is less than the allowable value of the this particular stress, tensile stress in the belt, hence the design of the belt is safe. In short, the solution of this particular numerical is written here. The diameter of the pulleys which you have to find out, it is 270 and 810. The length of belt 4982 and width of the belt 130 mm. And the belt tensions 1428.98 Newton and 692.26 Newton. Now we will go for the next numerical. So in this numerical now, there is a V belts are used. So there are actually three V belts are used to transmit the power from an electric motor which is running at 2800 RPM to a machine which is running at 700 RPM. So input speed is higher than the output speed. So reduction is there in the speed here. In this case, the center distance between the input and the output shaft is 800 mm. The shear groove angle is 38, because V groove angle, we call it as V pulley angle, is 38. And the coefficient of friction in this case is 0.5. So the density of belt material is specified here is 1100 kg per meter cube, and the allowable tensile stress for the belt material is 1.75 Newton per mm square. While the cross-sectional area of the belt is also specified, that is 600 mm square, and you are asked to find out the diameter of the pulleys, the maximum power that the belt to the belt can transmit, and the required initial tension in each belt. So first step is that we should write down the given data. So here you will find out the total data is specified with the input speed, output speed, then center distance, then V groove angle, density of material, belt stress, cross-sectional area of the belt, coefficient of friction. Okay, and we are considering that we are going to find out the value of D1, means it is input pulley diameter, and D2 is the output pulley diameter. So first, as the stress is given to us, so and cross-sectional area is also available with us, so we are going to find out the maximum tension, T max. So T max is equal to stress into area, that is 1.75 into 600, that is equal to 1050 Newton. And we know that for maximum power transmission condition, the centrifugal tension must be 1/3 of the maximum tension acting on a belt drive. So in this case, it is maximum tension 1050, so divided by 3, it is 350 Newton. And also we know that this centrifugal tension is given by mv square. So from here we can find out the velocity of the belt. So velocity of the belt will be under root of tc by m. So we are just replacing this term tc divided by m, and its root we are taking, so we will be getting this velocity as 23.028 meter per second. So once we get the velocity of the belt, then we can find out the pulley diameters. So velocity of belt is pi d1 n1 by 60,000, and therefore d1 is equal to v into 60,000 upon pi into n1. So velocity is written here, which is we found out in the previous slide, multiplied by 6000 divided by pi into n1 is 2800. So you are getting the first pulley diameter, which is equal to 157.07. This is nearly equal to 160 mm. So this is nothing but your motor pulley diameter. Now we will find out the machine pulley diameter. So again, by using the same velocity at the input and at the output, so v1 is equal to v2, considering that d2 will be is equal to n1 multiplied by d1 by n2. So n1 is 2800, d1 is 160, which you got here, and divided by 6700, which is the output RPM. So we are getting d2 is equal to 640 mm. Now we will try to get the belt tensions. So first of all, for calculating the belt tensions, we should find out the angle of wrap for the smaller pulley, because this angle of wrap for the smaller pulley is less than the angle of wrap for the larger pulley, and therefore we are using it for the power transmission. So in this case, you have to put the value of d2 and d1, which you obtained in the last slide, multiplied by divided by 2 into center distance, that is center distance 800. So we will be getting this alpha equal to 2.53 radians. Now the ratio of belt tensions is given by T1 minus mv square upon T2 minus mv square is equal to e raised to mu into alpha. So e raised to 0.5 is the value of mu, and alpha is 2.53, so we will be getting this ratio as 48.85. So we know that T1 is equal to 1050 and TC is equal to 350. So using this T1 TC, which is equal to mv square, so T1 and TC, there are two unknowns in this equation, so we are having the value of these two unknowns. So only unknown is the T2, so we will be getting the T2 by using this equation, which is equal to 364.32 newtons. Now once we got the T1, T2, TC, all these tensions, now we can find out the maximum power transmitted by this particular belt drive. So one belt can transmit the power, which is given by P is equal to T1 minus T2 into V is equal to T1 is 1050, T2 is 364.32 multiplied by velocity 23.02. So we'll be getting the power by one belt transmitted is 15 kilowatts or 15.78 kilowatt, and the power transmitted by the 3V belt is 3 multiplied by 15.78, so the total is 47.35 kilowatt. And the initial tension in the belt, if you have to find out, it will be equal to T1 plus T2 by 2. So T1 is this one, T2 is this one, divided by 2. So average of that will be nothing but the initial tension in the belt. So in short, we got the solution to this particular numerical. So first we are asked to find out the pulley diameters. So it is 160 and 640 mm. Then we are asked to find out the maximum power the belt can transmit, at which is equal to 47.35 kilowatt. And we are asked to find out the initial tension in each belt, so it is 707.16 newton. Now we will go for the next numerical. So here we will see that there is a pulley of 1000 mm diameter, which is driven by an open type of flat belt on 20 kilowatt 1440 rpm electric motor. So electric motor is used, which is having 20 kilowatt power, and 1440 rpm is the speed of that electric motor, and it is driven by a pulley of 1000 mm diameter, and the diameter of the pulley is 300 mm on the motor shaft, and the center distance between the pulley is 2 meter. So the coefficient of friction between the pulley and the belt is 0.28, while the density of the material is given as 900 kg per meter cube, and the allowable tensile stress for the belt material is 2 newton per mm square. And here the width of the belt is specified to us and asked to find out the thickness of the belt, and length of the belt you have to find out, and the initial tension required in the belt. So let us see, first of all, note down the total given data carefully, that is input RPM 1440 and input pulley diameter is 1000 mm. Then so here this is the output pulley diameter, D2 as 1000 and D1 as 300 mm. Okay, and belt stress 2 newton per mm square, coefficient of friction 0.28, and width of the belt is 1.25. So first step in the calculation is to know about the belt tensions used in this particular drive. So to calculate the belt tensions, we are first of all calculating the angle of wrap for the solar pulley, which is given by this equation. And here in this equation, you have to put the value of D2 and D1 and C, center distance, that is 2000. So we will be getting this 2.79 radian is the value of this alpha. So ratio of belt tensions will be T1 upon T2 raised to mu alpha. So we are going to put the value of mu as 0.28 and alpha as is actually 2.79. So we'll be getting this ratio as 2.183. So this is the one equation which we got for calculating the value of T1 and T2. So another equation we want, since there are two unknowns, so another equation can be power equation. So for calculating the power, we need the velocity. So let us calculate first of all velocity of the belt. So pi d1 n1 by 60,000, you will get velocity as 22.61 meter per second. And now we are using this equation of power, which is equal to T1 minus T2 into V. So T1 minus T2 will be equal to P by V, which is equal to 884.194 Newton. So using this equation of T1 minus T2 and previous equation of T1 by T2, we'll be getting the value of T1 and T2 as 1631.0 Newton and 746.81 Newton. So in this case, the centrifugal tension is equal to mv square. So m is equal to v into t, that is area and length 1 meter, and the density multiplied by v square. So you will be getting this tc is equal to 57.55 times t. As we have to find out the belt thickness now, so we should know the maximum tension and the stress value in the belt. So maximum tension will be equal to t1 plus tc. Here we will calculate. So 1631 plus 57.55 times t, and stress given to us is 2 newton per mm square. So stress is equal to maximum tension by cross section of the belt, so t max by a. So we are putting this value of t max here and cross section area. So both these terms are in terms of t, that is, this is to be equal to stress value, that is 2. So solving this, we will get the value of t as 8.475 mm, which may be nearly equal to 8.5 mm. So and tc now we can find out, which is equal to 57.55 times t multiplied by this t. If I make it, is 487.83 newton I will get. So finally, you have to find out initial tension in the belt, so which is equal to t1 plus t2 plus 2 tc by 2. So it is 1631 plus 746.81 plus 2 into 487.383 divided by 2. So this is another approach. In this approach, actually, we have considered separately this tc, while in the previous numerical we have considered the tc within the equation of ta by t1 by t2. So I will discuss this, what is the difference in this, solving this two way of problem in the next slide. So finally, here in this case, you have to find out the center distance c, the length of belt. So for that, we need a center distance and we need the diameters. So center distance is 2000 and the diameter is d1 and d2 is 300 and 1000. And we will get this length of belt is 6103.28, that is nearly equal to 6104. So here again, now if I do check whether the design is correct or not. So maximum allowable stress is 2 Newton per mm square, and stress equation is here. Induced stress we will find out. So maximum force, that is T max divided by cross section area. So this is the T1 plus TC is the T max. Cross section is 1062. So we are getting this stress as 1.994, which is definitely again less than the 2 Newton per mm square, and therefore we can say that the design is safe over here. So in short, the solution of this numerical is, so you have to find out thickness of the belt, so it is 8.5 mm, length of belt 6104 mm, and the required initial tension in each belt is 1676.74 Newton. Similarly, you can also try for one of the numerical which is specified here. So let us understand what is given here. So there is a one compressor which is running at 750 rpm, and it is driven by an electric motor running at 1500 rpm through the 8x225 mm flat leather belt. So it is a flat leather belt problem, flat belt problem, in which input RPM is 1500 and output RPM is 750 RPM. The compressor is run by this particular electric motor, and the center distance between these two is 1.5 meter, while the coefficient of friction between the belt and the pulley is 0.35, and the belt mass is 900 kg per cubic meter. While if the allowable tensile stress for the material is 2 Newton per mm square, you have to determine the tension in the belt and the maximum power transmission capacity of the belt. So first you will just note down the given data like this, and then you will try to attempt this particular numerical. So if you refer different books, you will find out basically this particular belt drive problem is solved in a two different way. In some books, actually, the approach used is like this. It means actually there is a basic difference between the equation of this belt tension. So if you use the belt tension equation like this, in which you will subtract this TC, centrifugal tension, from here. So T1 minus TC upon T2 minus TC is equal to e raised to mu into alpha upon sine of beta by 2. This is for the V belt, and for the flat belt it will be only mu into alpha e raised to power. So in this case, the T1 will be considered as a T max, while initial tension the belt required will be T1 plus T2 by 2, and power equation will be again same like T1 minus T2 into V, that much watts. So basically, tension on tight side in this case will be T1, and tension on slack side in this case will be T2. While in other case, in some books, the problem is solved like this. So they are considering the T max is equal to T1 plus TC. And this ratio of belt tension, they are considering T1 upon T2 is equal to E raised to mu into alpha upon sine of beta by 2. It means they are not considering this TC, and therefore they are adding this TC over here. Similarly, when you calculate the initial tension in the belt, so T1 plus T2 plus 2 TC by 2. So again, they are considering this TC over here, and P is equal to T1 minus T2 into V, means power equation will remain same. So in this case, tension on tight side will be T1 plus TC, and tension on slack side will be T2 plus TC. Well, in this case only T1 and T2 were the tension on tight side and slack side. In this case, this TC is to be added, because this is that TC is not considered in this equation. So there are these two major difference by which the particular numericals are solved in different books. Okay, so we'll stop here. Thank you. Thank you very much.